हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी आर विद द सेकंड एपिसोड ऑफ सेलेनियम इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स फॉर फ्रेशर्स एंड एक्सपीरियंस्ड। सो लेट गेट स्टार्टेड। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ड्राइवर्स अवेलेबल इन द वेब ड्राइवर। द आंसर इज फायरफॉक्स ड्राइवर, इंटरनेट एक्सप्लोरर ड्राइवर, क्रोम ड्राइवर, सफारी ड्राइवर, ओपेरा ड्राइवर, एंड्रॉयड ड्राइवर एंड आईफोन ड्राइवर, HTML unit driver. So these drivers are nothing but when we are working with those respective browsers like Firefox, Chrome, Internet Explorer and other browsers, and these drivers help us to handle those commands and which can execute in their respective browsers. And we move on to the next question. What is a Selenium 2.2? The answer is what it's a combination of RC and web driver, which is called as Selenium 2.2, and Selenium remote control is called as Selenium 1. And there is an advanced feature which is added to the Selenium 2.0, which is called as Selenium 3.0. And we'll move on to the next question. How many test cases you have automated per day? And this is the most confusing and tricky interview questions in most interviews. This is asked for both freshers and experienced guy. And it is depends on the complexity and length of the test cases. It may be varies based on the complexity. Like I can automate 2 to 5 test cases if my test scenario has less complexity. If those complexity is increased, then I can automate only one test case per day. So this is based on the person to person. It varies person to person based on their experiences. Generally, we can automate 2 to 5 test cases per day. And we'll move on to the next questions. So what are the benefits of automation testing? So this is also one of the important questions. It may be asked in both freshers and experienced guy, but mostly for freshers. So it is like answer is it saves the time and money, and it is more reliable because it can be run at any time of any point of time. And its major use is like reusability. We can use those test cases for smoke test, functional test, regression test, and we have an easy reporting. So we can report those results in a quickly, and it has a low maintenance, unlike we have a manual testing in the long run. And it is a best use when it is a regression testing, because executing 1,000 test cases by manual process is really hard, but this automation will resolve those, and which is very useful in terms of automation regression test cases. And it reduces the manual intervention. So no manual intervention is needed in the automation testing. We'll move on to the next question. So what are the challenges in the Selenium? So this is a important question as part of for experienced guy. So the answer is Selenium supports only a web-based application, because we cannot perform mobile testing or mobile-based applications or desktop-based application. We can perform only web-based applications, and there is no vendor support, unlike we have HP QTP. So it has no vendor support, and for reporting this Selenium need to depend on third party tools like TestNG, Xlrt and Extend Report. So it doesn't have inbuilt reporting, so we need to rely on the third party tools. And as there is no object repository concept in Selenium, so maintenance of that object concept is very difficult here. So maintainability of the object is very difficult in the Selenium. So these are some of the challenges in the Selenium. So we'll discuss more in the next upcoming episode of interview questions. I hope this small session is useful for you. In case if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel and do share your questions in my comment section. Thank you.